week number two of Beginning Windy Hop in South Portland. So we're going to just go through as a review of the things we did in video number one. Looks like this. We've got the basic board and back. We've got the flip flop. We've got the lead goes in front and goes back to the follow side. So that's a review of what we did in video one. And if you're watching this video for the first time, I'm leading, Aaron's following. And then for this week, we changed it up just a little bit, and instead of the lead going in front, we put the follow in front. So it goes a one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven. So we talked about how the lead's very similar to this flip-flop. The leads open up to bring the follow in front. It feels the same, except for the lead doesn't go anywhere. Let's show that one from the side too. So we've got a rock, step, follow in front, step, step. We also talked about how the follows need to go all the way to the end of the line there. So all the way back in the lead's hand, and then all the way to the end of the line, so they get this little stretch to come back to their lead. Then we took those two ideas of the lead in front and follow in front. We did something called promenade. So the promenade looks like this, rock, step, the lead goes in front, and then we just walk, walk, and I bring the follow to my side. Walk, walk. And then we did the follow in front. So we've got a rock, step, triple, and walk, walk, triple, rock, step, triple, and walk, walk, triple. So biggest things we worked on or talked about were leads, just making those really clear leads between neutral arm, you're just going forward and back, and you're leading something if you open up to do the flip-flop, or maybe you open up to bring your follow in front. And then follows really worked on hanging back, magnetic, you want a magnetic connection between the follow's back and the lead's right hand, and that way it becomes a true lead and follow dance. Anything else I missed? Okay, that's it. Thank you, guys.